Hello everyone, my name is Naresh Dhopal and today's session is a little bit theoretical. I know people do not like theories, but we cannot really avoid this because there are some basic concepts of any technology which are very important to know for improving any skills, and this is one of them. But no worries, I will try to keep it very short and this is gonna be interesting too, trust me. Second important thing is these topics are separated with their titles. So if you are already familiar with some topics, you can jump to next title. But still, I would recommend you to go through at least once to recall things before moving to the coding part or in practices. Okay, enough foundation. So let's quickly start and go through them one by one. So we will start from exploring silicon chips or integrated circuits or ICs, and we will understand its uses. Second, we will know why HDLs are so important for digital system design. Third, we will have a little background of VHDL. Fourth, we will give a quick compare to VHDL and Verilog HDL. Fifth will be the FPGA briefing. Sixth, we will give a quick compare to FPGA and ASIC. Seven, you will know about the FPGA design tools. Eight will be the VHDL simulation, and I will be explaining behavioral simulation and gate level simulation. Nine will be the VHDL synthesis. And then in the last, we will understand the VHDL design flow. Let's jump into our first topic, that is, why silicon chips? So you must be familiar with the term silicon chips or ICs. So do I really need to tell you where these things are being used? I guess no, right? Because these are everywhere, from a basic electronic device to a very complex system. These are in your mobile phones, in your laptops, PCs, these are in your cameras, IoT devices, automation systems, these are in cars, servers, toys, electronics instruments, satellite, medical equipments, and so there are many, many different areas and devices where these are being used. In single statement, I can say almost every electronic device has chip inside at present time. Do you agree? If you remember a couple of years back, when there was a shortage of electronic chips, every segment and area has that impact in terms of cost and supply. So now you can assume the life without those chips when they are not supplying or they are limited. Okay, let's make this topic a little interesting. Can you name a digital system or a gadget which you think has a chip inside, but that is unique to you? I mean, that should not be common. So let me know from the comment section. But make sure that gadget should not be very common. In this discussion, we will look at why we need to use VHDL for designing and simulating logic for FPGAs and ASICs, and we will look into a design process flow. So let's get started. First, let's understand that why we wanted to use a hardware description language like VHDL and Verilog HDL to create our digital system. We will try to understand this with an example. If you look over this logic symbol on the schematics, question is, what do you think with this? Some of you will say it's a multiplexer or mux, or some will say it's a switch, or some may describe it with its function that input A or input B will go to the output depends on the select input. Say if select input is 0, input A will be the output, or if select pin is 1, input B will be the output. And I will say all the statements are correct. Okay, so based on the description, if you wanted to map a truth table for a multiplexer, it would be like this. If you don't know what is truth table, then in one line, truth table is a relation between inputs and outputs for all the possible combination of all the inputs. So here, in case of two input and one output multiplexer, there are total 8 digital possibilities. You can take a pause here and have a detailed look. It shows when select pin S is 0, input A will be the output, and if select pin S is 1, input B will be the output. Now assume, if you wanted to design a digital system of this symbol multiplexer into FPGA or ASIC, or you wanted to design an integrated circuit for this, you would be needing a schematic structure of logical elements, I mean logical gates like here. Try to understand this. Input B and input select are going to the inputs of AND gate, then input A and NOT gate of input select are going to input of another AND gate, and then output of both AND gates are going to input of our gate, and output of our gate will be the output of our multiplexer. That means our multiplexer schematic design would be something like this. Complex, right? And it will be more complex when you plan it to integrate into the ICs, because that required a low level design as well. Normally series transistor level design and layout level design. Now just assume, instead of this simple multiplexer, think of the current generation ICs which are being developed at 3 nanometer technology and having billions of transistors and logical gates. Can you design them with the basic logical elements and gates and schematic diagrams? No. That means designing a function using basic logical elements is not an effective way of digital system design. So, what's the alternative we have? A better way to design a digital system would be to describe a behavior of a digital system and let design tools figure out what logic or structure is required to implement that function. So here, the HDL comes in picture. In this case, we would describe the behavior as if input select is 0, then output gets the value of input A, else if input select is 1, then output gets the value of input B. And let's leave everything to the tool to design a system for this function. So as long as tools correctly implement this behavior, we really don't care what logical diagram tools created for us. We simply want a digital system that behaves like we described it to behave. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and leave a comment below, and don't forget to subscribe for regular updates.